Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's SwissMan15, and welcome back to another online battle for Medieval 2 Total War. This one is in the Britannia expansion. I know what you're thinking, Britannia, what? I see the Turks, but yes, I'm playing the Turks in the Britannia expansion in an online battle. And as you can see, I'm also without any cab. I'm making my own form of a new box, somewhat of a state box, but also having no backline of pikes nor stakes, but just spearmen. So as you can see, it's going to be interesting for me. Over here, we have my future opponent in this battle, England, played by Sweet. You can see he's got all those awesome two-handers, he's got his longbowmen all ready to come and attack my lines. Our other two opponents, which we will also see fight off, are Charlie Otero. He will be commanding the Holy Roman Empire with the awesome Zweihänder and Gothic Knights. They're actually good in the expansions, and they look awesome as well. I mean, check out those swords. They're even better when you have the armor upgrade, so they're all like curvatured. And then over here, finally but not last leastly, we have Wales, played by Andrelamagod, something like that. He's playing Wales. I'll just call him Andre or Andre. I don't know, whatever he wants to be called. I'll find it in the future, but I'll call him Andre for now. He is playing Wales. So let's go straight into this. Probably speed up for the beginning. I have artillery, and so does Charlie Otero over there, and we tend to make good use of our artillery, at least when we have it. Some people haven't done it such, but this serpentine is of course very deadly, especially with its massively long range. I'm not sure what Charlie's doing over here. He's sending some Teutonic Knights over to the flank, and they are probably heavily upgraded. I think they might even have two armor upgrades, despite the cost effect. Yes, they do. So these must cost him well over thousands of ones. If I had to guess, I think it'd be somewhere around 1,700 for just a single unit with all those upgrades, so that's kind of excessive to spend on one unit. If you take a quick glance at my lines over here, I have some Ottoman infantry, also Turkish archers, mostly a lot of Janissary archers because they deployed the stakes. I got a cannon, I got a trebuchet, I got three Saracen militia in the Schiltraum formation, one of my general in the center. A lot of this is adapted from Paladin Bob's tactics, sort of molded it into my own form to use as the Turks, a lot of it was taken from his original idea. And just sort of suited more so to fit my type of box. He likes more spearmen, heavy infantry combo. I thought, well, you know, spearmen in the Schiltraum is awesome, but I also like heavy infantry spearmen over here, like the Sipahi Lancers, which he did too, but they couldn't do the Schiltraum, so it's a give and take there. And also got more Janissary heavy infantry as a shock factor and Nafatoons instead of massively powerful longbowmen, especially with Wales or the Swatha. England is coming in over here. He's marching through the forest. You can tell it's got a lot of trees in this map, so it's kind of a damper on the situation. Over here, the HRE has done nothing much yet. The Welsh, I think, are repositioning at this point. You might get a glimpse of their army with all their rifalier, something like that, rifalier. Welsh militiamen, interesting. Don't they have axes? Yes. So this could be a good flanking force that he's got right there. He's got a lot more horses than I think he should have as Wales. They're more of a pike faction, not a pike, a stake faction, more so anti-cav. He doesn't seem to have a lot of spearmen either, so I don't know where his money went or at all. He might have more archers that are hidden that I can't see right now. If we look over here, there should be the English army. There it is. Hello, Mr. English army. His cav doesn't seem to have any upgrades. I don't know where his money went. If I had to guess, maybe. Don't even know. Wow. It's hard to tell. There might be some attack upgrades. I don't see any experience anywhere. He's starting to rush forward with all his cavalry heading down to this flank, probably to get around to the side that I don't have any stakes on. Though he couldn't charge, the spearmen will do an excellent job of just repelling cav charges altogether. So I don't want to be too hasty there, wishing some cases he might have been. You can see my trebuchet firing off in the distance. If we look over here, these two are still not engaged at all whatsoever. So I'm going to go back to the English fight, just making sure I don't miss anything too crucial, but in fact I'll probably miss both battles while I switch between the two. just not enough time, not enough time. You can see my Ottoman infantry, I think, are the ones firing these missiles, also maybe some Janissary archers, taking out a good portion of these knights from afar. That's at least five dead over there. And I'm pretty sure you'll see some artillery shots coming in pretty soon. Yeah, you can see the smoke of one blast here, and also all the arrow fire. Ooh, trebuchet coming in. Come on, kill them. Kill them all. Oh, this is satisfying. Look at all the arrows come in. Look at them go. Alright, do I get a good blast with... I'm pretty sure I killed some of his troops. Oh yeah, these guys were hit with a blast somewhere back here, probably. I'm not going to see it though, am I? Okay, oh well. Ooh, that was... Ooh! That was right in front of the screen. But getting some kills with the trebuchet, which is good to see. Always good to get some actual kills. My archers do not have a good skirmish advantage here, especially since he has a hill. But he does have less of them, and he doesn't get them into the loose formation, which is maybe not the best idea. But also, here comes in his infantry all charging in. Just going to quickly check back the other battle, which has not yet started, but it seems that the Welsh do have the spearmen that I thought they should have, and their archers are coming into position along with some Welsh militiamen. Look at all the arrows come in. The English coming in, they're getting a good charge. Actually routed my Turkish archers with some mailed knights, but I got my spearmen coming out to engage them and definitely make short work of them in a melee at least. You can see his longbowmen arrows are coming in, they're raining down and taking out tons of my troops on their own. And as his troops come in for the engagement, my Janissary heavy infantry are forming up to take him on. Some cav charges here, but they, you can see, widely repelled by these spearmen, which I loved because they have the armor upgrades and they are good quality spearmen at that. So they will do short work against any cav charges, which is lovely to see. Not as good as pikemen, of course, but still effective enough for the time being. I'm just trying to reposition my lines, make sure he doesn't get any breaches with his heavy infantry. You can see they're starting to wrap around over here, getting some engagement against my spearmen, which is smart of him. And also you can see a big hole in my lines, which I quickly send to fill with these Saracen militia and Janissary heavy infantry. Don't want to cause any lines that he can puncture through and ruin my state box with. I can't even speak right now. Over here, wow, it seems the Welsh got a pretty good charge on, actually, taking out a good number of these Gothic knights with a single charge. But you can see also the HREs coming out with his own cav, entering the engagement. Teutonic knights are now routing, unfortunately. His general's bodyguard of the Welsh are coming out and maybe going to go for a charge themselves. But these Teutonic knights seem very safe enough now. And he's also got some returning, but let's see this charge. Probably going to be pretty good. Yeah, taking out a... Oh, wow, actually... really cutting in, but now he's in danger of getting chopped down and surrounded, and which he does. This could really prove fatal for the general, maybe. Let's see if he gets out. Probably going to take a good number of casualties on the way out, but he did get an effective charge there. Now the Welsh are pushing forward with all their inferior cav, trying to probably hope to make the best out of them. Their archers also doing a great support against the cavalry of the Holy Roman Empire. And also, here come the spearmen, but also out of formation, which may not be the best thing. See, these guys are all on their own. They probably won't be able to last long. Oh, that serpentine blast, though. But quickly checking back over at the battle over here, you can see the English infantry has now thusly engaged my own. And but on the bright side, I have broken through his lines over here, his infantry lines. His cavalry is now starting to flee, more or less. You can see a lot of them died over here against my spearmen. And here seems to be a charge coming in straight for the stakes, which I certainly love. There goes one, actually. Two, three, two. That died on the stakes. Oh well. Also, you can see my Nafatoons, which I did leave behind earlier, are now throwing. Taking out some of these troops, hoping for some morale effect, because you can see my lines are getting pretty thin against his own. I also got my Janissary heavy infantry going up here. Also, Saracen militia going up to Dingate, take down his archers that have the hill position, if they can manage to do so. Over here, the HRE and Welsh now have their line engagement going. These infantry are not to be messed with, especially against Welsh militiamen. I'm pretty sure the Swahinder have an excellent edge. You can see some of them already routing. The Welsh lines don't seem too well defined, which may prove fatal for his entire cause here. Though he's got his spearmen in a good formation to be surrounded in, but they are unhappy to be surrounded at that. He's got his own two-handers, are pretty decent, but not the best of the two-handers in the world. They're just okay. The general's bodyguard is still nice and safe, and you got all his Swather pounding the enemy cavalry, it seems, with their missile shots, taking out a good number. So far, you can see three dead over here, which is always good to see cavalry dying on the other side. But his infantry seems to be completely failing him, which could actually turn the game against him, sadly enough. Over here, you can see the English lines have just started to break completely. The Nafatoons have done their job at that. My lines are actually really scarce. You see my infantry down to 15, very low numbers, but I'm just hoping to rout him as much as I can. He's coming in for another charge with his general's bodyguard. Ooh, Nafatoons doing their job. And actually, he's getting a lot more of an effective charge considering that my spearmen were not in formation, which was good, but I have more spearmen coming in to support. I think this is my general's unit, actually. It might be. Probably. Just scared he might die. If it is the actual general's unit, or is that it? Might be this one. No, it's this one. Yes, there goes his general fleeing, followed by another cavalry charge right in the back of my spearmen, which is a lot more effective than a frontal charge. Actually taking out at least 20 or so of these spearmen. Unfortunately, that's pretty good of a charge. Just got to get the spearmen out of formation to get a good charge on them, it seems. Over here, it seems that the Welsh lines have completely broken to the HRE. All he has left is his archers. They don't have the best of morale in the game, so he's just got to probably hold off with whatever force he's got and hope that his missiles can really take out the majority of the lines here. But you can see there's a good charge coming in by the general's bodyguard of the HRE, probably going to really take out all this line, and yes, it does. Look at it go. Oh, that entire unit's going to break, and it's probably going to cause a chain rout along his entire lines, and I think you can safely call this match decided in favor of the HRE. He's got his archers completely nice on their own, taking shots, and his infantry coming in to take out the remainder of the fleeing and scattered Welsh forces, few and far between that they are. If you look over here, my stake box has held. The English pretty much are non-existent against me anyway. At this point, all he's got are some longwomen, which are now fleeing from my Saracen militia. What such cowards that they are. Actually routing now. Before they were just fleeing. Actually, he admitted defeat at this point, which is good for me, because I had no cavalry to chase him down with whatsoever. All I had was some loosely made archers and uselessly supplied at that. I said at that a lot as a phrase. At that. And ooh, another charge by the general of the HRE, taking out a lot more of the Swather, but also it seems that he did take some hits on his own. Are any of them going to die? Nope, just some Welsh calf. Come on, Wales, I'm rooting for you, because I have to face the remainder of the HRE forces, which are now coming in the Swyhander. Very well prepared to take on cavalry and infantry alike. So that's good for them. Just walking. Oh, this general's probably going to die soon. Doesn't seem to stand much of a chance. But the Swather are doing a good number against lines, taking out some of these troops. But it's just too little too late for the Welsh, no matter what he does. He doesn't have the manpower, and his general is now dead. So that is the end of Andre. He has lost the battle. It's down to me and Charlie for the finales of this match, in which case I will speed up. The engagement actually takes here. I take the hill because I can tell that my forces are far inferior in number and I don't have the necessary forces to maintain a formation of any sort. And I'm wasting ammo here and that is bad. I could have actually done a lot if I had noticed they were shooting. Wow, that would have been four volleys. Save for later. That later come into effect because you will see that a lot of my forces have to go into melee. And it's a very close one, and you would see who wins. Oh, it's a nail-biter. Some spearmen fleeing by the Welsh up the hill. So let us just speed it on up. You can see in the distance the HRE forces are reforming down in the original valley clearing that they had. Nice for them. And their artillery, full number, not even touched, unfortunately, for me. And his infantry, and also a pretty good number, especially with all these two-handers Archers, very well populated as well. Just, he's low on cav, but it doesn't matter. It's always going to be more than a person who has no cav whatsoever. All I had was spearmen and infantry, which are now heavily depleted. Mostly I got just archers for the melee, just a few units, and I still got a few Nafatoons that I'm hopefully going to do some damage with. So you can see me coming up to this clearing, hopefully for a good position for my trebuchet and cannon to get some good shots before he can come and take me on, because I want to get every unit dead that I can. Just one cannon, because so many of my cannon unit actually died in the fight down by my stake box, as you may see. Look at all of them. Just, these were all just shot to bits. That's all of the casualties here, was just shots. And you can see his cavalry all died along these two flanks here, mostly at the hands of my spearmen, some at my archers, and a little bit at my stakes here and here. And the rest of the infantry just mostly routed, or returned from routing, or just died to some much better suited Janissary heavy infantry, especially with armor and attack upgrades, since I didn't pay for any cavalry, which are twice as expensive as infantry in this, pretty much. Okay, now we got the artillery engagement beginning. You can see that I'm going in with my cannon, missing the first shot, but I'm just trying to get into a position where I can get more damage on him before he makes a move. His serpentine's in range, but I'm not too intimidated because he's firing uphill, so this is probably not going to get too many good shots on me. Whew, that was actually a blast, it seems, right there. Alright. So let's just slow down. Ooh, you can see right there my trebuchet actually getting two kills on some Swyhander. So now he sends up his Pavi's crossbowmen, which I am not happy to see, because they are excellent at skirmishing, even uphill against regular bowmen. Even though bowmen are much better in this game, mine are tired and they are the bulk of my forces. So I don't want to waste them, because they're going to have to be my infantry later on. And I think he just destroyed one of our trebuchets, if you heard that. Let's see. Yep, one of them is going down right now. Oh, wait, no. It's just flinging. I thought it got destroyed. Wow. Okay. It sounded like wood was breaking. Apparently, I was hallucinating. You can see my archers are now beginning their firing on the HRE archers, but they're at such a long range that it doesn't seem too effective quite yet. But now here comes in the real hail. You can see a lot of the enemy crossmen are now dying, which is a great sight for me in any case. And now his infantry are following up the attack, which I am not happy to see. Yes, trebuchet, kill! Getting some of these crossbowmen to die, but his crossbolts are very effective. You'll see that they will... Oh, yeah, just like that, killing my men. Doesn't even matter if they kill less, they are going to do enough that they will damage my lines unhealably. If, honestly, if I were the HRE, I would have tried to draw out this engagement, because the crossmen will have, the archers of the HRE will have more ammo than I can ever hope to have, or at least last long in the fight, because you can see my Janissary archers already pulling out their daggers and going for the engagement with some scattered infantry support. And I'm using focusing fire now on the enemy infantry, because they don't have shields. I'm hoping for some good effect. And here they come in from my pathetically surmounted lines. That's all I can really muster as a line whatsoever. Just really not too much at all. And he's got the charge, but I got a good shield. Charge resistant infantry, at the very least. And my Nafatoon's right here to do some damage. You can see some of them are actually routing already, which is what I need to just break up this line before anything happens. And really the only thing I had was morale effect here, because my spearmen took a heavy beating against this charge of heavy infantry of the HRE. You can see actually here he's overwhelming this flank. I don't have any real troops to help, and he's actually got my archers now over here in a melee, and they are definitely outclassed. But probably maybe a little bit better on the stamina side of things, so just hoping that that could cause some rout factor here. The HRE getting some charges in, but it's blocked by his own infantry, which is good for me. I'm getting the remainder of my depleted archers into the fight, trying to just hold my lines and plug in wherever I can, hoping that my Nafatoons will do the work, but you can see his crossbows are finally taking them down, dwindling them in forces. Ooh, take out the general, yes. Not close enough to the actual general, but taking on the unit now, and it's coming into an engagement with these Ottoman infantry, which are wavering and tired, So I need to get my general in some here, somewhere here. I think my general, in fact, is over here. I wonder, where is he? But these Saracen militia are actually taking on head-on-head these Gothic knights, which is pretty impressive considering they're spearmen. Luckily, the Gothic knights are very tired at this point because they don't have the greatest of stamina with their heavy armor. It does tire them out quicker than other units, as you will see. At least making them sprint does, and yes, surround them before you can even get there. He almost took them out, my Naphtoons. You can see a lot of his troops are now pretty much gone. My infantry is winning the engagement, but his crossbows are still completely untouched and his cavalry is still harassing my own troops. Now you can see I'm getting my general into the mix. This should be the general's unit, I do think. Maybe? No. Maybe not. I don't know. Where is my general? He could be anywhere. And here comes some more Zweihänder to help these Gothic knights that are fighting me off. But luckily, his crossbow bolts are actually taking on more of him than me, it seems. And his cav just took a huge beating there from my spearmen. Which I will take, because I need anything and everything to fight this, because you can see my troops are getting surrounded. Luckily, I have the numerical advantage in the infantry fight, but look at all these crossbow bolts coming in and actually really taking out my lines. And the last of my Janissary of infantry, I think you just saw, died. Poor guy. Trying to get into some information here. You can see my general. There he is. Scared for his life, but he will be the beacon that holds my men together as these spearmen fight for their lives against these exhausted heavy infantry of the HRE. I'm trying to go for some flanks here with my Ottoman infantry. They don't have the best morale, so I'm kind of scared they will rout, but I need to do whatever I can to get an advantage so I can take on his archers before all my units are shot to death completely. And you can see, look at the crossbows coming in and cutting me down, really. Oh, look at all of them, just died. They're just dead because of that. I guess that's what happens in war, they just die. It's a weird way for me to say it, so I was mocking myself, you didn't catch that. I can't speak today. But really, when can I speak? And I only have 18 frames right now? Looks a lot better than 18 frames to me. You can see the last of the Zweihänder here. Ooh. Yeah, maybe not the best frames of the world. Oh god. Oh god, the Serpentine doing number, actually routing a good number of my Ottoman infantry. And at this point, it seems too little too late for what I have. My troops are in too few number to really take on the remainder of his crossbows now, because he's still got infantry here, and he's got his general, of course. I mean, I do too, but my troops are not too happy here. Though I do manage to rout him, I win the infantry fight, but not the battle. At last, because his general's still here, the final man in his general's unit, and the rest of his crossbows in such massive number. Though they're not the best at melee, my troops are too few to even try to surmount and catch up to the enemy. Oh, and the Serpentine is not helping my case whatsoever. Look at all these crossbows just taking out this entire unit of Ottoman infantry, which now rout. And just one by one, they will all fall. My first unit, maybe these Sipahi Lancers will make it, because they're still happy. Come on, kill one guy. There you go, kill two guys. There you go, kill three guys. They're not happy anymore. Probably gonna die soon. Or just rout, rather than anything else. Oh, there goes one, slain. Here comes the Janissary Archer, the last one, his troop. These two last ones, one routes, one captured. There we go, and there goes the last of my forces, pretty much, besides artillery. So I think I admit defeat now. Yep. And that is the end of the battle. So, Charlie doing really well, 1,166 kills and 227 captures, so very nicely done. Andre Lemegard not doing too hot this battle, only 460 kills. Sweet, doing adequate for a loss, 600 kills, and I'm myself getting 993. If you look at the stats here, the majority of my kills, I think, go to Janissary Heavy Infantry with 8180. My Archer's doing not too shabby at all. Naphtoon's actually getting 45, but 68 and 65 for some Archers, and nothing else. Turkish Archer's doing abysmally with 5, probably because they got charged, but All right, pretty good numbers here. Thank you all for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and tell me all what you think of the battle and start your own expansion battles. I do recommend them. And I'll see you all next time. Goodbye, my friends.